Did you know that you can use Apple Notes to create a beautiful and fully functional travel itinerary that you can keep in the palm of your hands to make your vacation unforgettable? Stick around and find out how. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and everyone loves to travel, but nobody likes to create or track down those travel itineraries. In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to create a beautiful travel itinerary using Apple Notes with a little bit of help from ChatGPT. Make sure you stick around for my MacWhisperer power tip. Trust me, your Mac will thank you for it. Let's hop on in and get started. The first thing we need to do is figure out where we want to go, how long we're going to be there, and what kind of things we want to do while we're there. For this example, I'm going to take a trip to Japan for 3 days. Now, I could easily hire a travel agent and find out what flights to take, what hotels to stay at, what restaurants to go to, or I could just Google it and search through hundreds of websites to try and figure out the best trip. But it's 2024 and we've got the internet and ChatGPT. So my first step is to open the ChatGPT app from my dock down at the bottom here. But most people underutilize it. They'll come into ChatGPT and give a prompt something like this. I'm going to Japan for 3 days, what should I do? And ChatGPT will take that prompt and give you a little bit of information. Maybe detailed, maybe not. Just kind of depends. It's hit or miss. If you're a little more experienced with ChatGPT, you might do a more complicated prompt using a phrase like, act as if you're a travel agent and build me a 3-day itinerary. Now, again, maybe we get good stuff, maybe we don't. It just kind of depends. You can spend a whole lot of time with ChatGPT trying to perfect the results you're getting from her. You can give all sorts of information and cross your fingers. But other people have already done that work. And so the next thing I want to do is come up to the ChatGPT section here and click down below where it says Explore GPTs. These are separately created ChatGPT agents that have specific information, like how to help with your writing, how to be more productive, how to do research and analysis, and all sorts of other things. In this case, I'm going to come up to the search bar and I'm going to type travel. This is going to give me ChatGPT agents that are already trained to do what I'm trying to do. Now down below here, we're going to see Japan Travel Planner. I want to go to Japan. That's perfect. There are a lot of these GPTs. You may have to experiment with them to find out which ones work best for you. But in this case, let's try out the Japan Travel Planner. I'm going to click on it and I'm going to click Start Chat right here. To get me started on the right foot with this GPT, I've designed a prompt that asks for everything that I'm looking for. It tells the GPT that it's Japan, I'm going for 3 days, I want to put as many things on my agenda as possible, I want to experience great dinners, tourist destinations, I want to go karaokeing at least once, I want at least 2 different hotels, and I want to experience different transportations, maybe a bus, maybe a train, maybe a bike, whatever the different options are. So I'm going to let this GPT do the work for me. Now let's take a look and let's see what we got. In this 3-day itinerary, we're going to Tokyo for day 1. We can see that we're going to a market. We've got a nice restaurant. We've got a nice dinner at a sushi place. We're going to do karaoke. That sounds like a lot of fun. And then we've got our hotel information. In day 2, we're traveling to Kyoto. We take a bullet train to get there. We go to the Fushimi Shrine, which sounds like a lot of fun. Here's a geisha experience evening. That's going to be a ton of fun. A night dinner. There's our hotel information. And in the 3rd day, we go to Osaka. This looks like a great travel itinerary. And because I chose the right prompt and gave it the right information, it's even given me links to some popular guidebooks, as well as addresses, phone numbers, and web links for all the places we're going. This is perfect. Now let's take this information and let's put it into a note and let's format it a little bit. The easiest way to transfer things from GPT over to Notes is to use this little button here that is the copy button. So I'm going to click that copy button. Now let's hop over to Notes and let's create a new note by clicking our New Note button here. One of my favorite tricks when I'm building something in Notes is to open the note into its own page. So I'm going to double click on this new note here to give me a fresh, clean page. And now let's paste in the information from GPT. All right, here we've got everything we need, except there's a little bit of an issue. you may have noticed that there's all of these asterisks and pound signs that show up automatically when you transfer stuff from GPT over to Notes or other programs. That's because GPT uses a text formatting tool called Markdown, and many programs aren't yet updated to utilize Markdown. Unfortunately, Notes is one of them. But with a couple of quick formatting tricks that I'm going to teach you right now, we can easily fix that. The first thing we want to do is we want to perform a find. Command F will pull up the find tool like this, giving us a whole banner to find anything we need. In this case, I'm going to hit a couple of asterisks, and we'll see they show up all the way throughout this entire document, cluttering it up in a way that I don't want it. Over on the right side here, you'll notice an option to replace. So I'm going to click replace, and in the replace section, I'm going to just leave it blank, which essentially will replace all of these asterisks by deleting them. So I'm going to click over here, and I'm going to select replace all. And immediately, all of that formatting's gone, but I still need to tweak it a little bit to make it perfect. Let's click Done to get rid of our Find bar, and let's highlight our title here. Let's assume we like this title. I'm gonna come over to the formatting tools here and make it a full title, make it a little bit bigger. And then as we come down to each day, I'm gonna click on the formatting tool and I'm gonna make that a heading. And here's a great tip for you. If you need to customize and format a note, you don't have to manually do it. You can copy your text style and paste that onto the other parts of the document. So if I select this section right here and I come under the format menu and I come down to where it says font, I can copy or paste style. But take a look at what that key code is. It's Command Option C and Command Option V. So I'm gonna click the menu here. But when I come down to the second section here, I'm just gonna use the key code. Option Command V will take care of it there. I can come down to this section, Option Command V, and immediately update it. And I can even come down to the guidebooks at the bottom and Command plus Option plus V, change that as well. When you're working with notes, learning how to easily copy and paste different styles is gonna simplify everything that we have to do. Now to make this note beautiful and perfect, I'm gonna add a photograph. Let's hop right down to Safari. And I've already done a search for pictures of Japanese travel, showing beautiful Japanese landscapes. I really like this one. I'm gonna click on it, and I'm going to drag and drop this right onto the top of our note right there. This not only makes it look better, but it'll make it easier for us to find it inside of the Notes app. The next step to making this travel itinerary look perfect is to take the information they've given for each of these activities and add some web links that have some images to them. As you can see right here, it's added a web link, which is great, but it didn't give me a preview image. So I'm gonna come right to this website by clicking on the link here. And then once I'm on the website, I'm gonna grab this little icon to the left of the address bar and drag it. We're gonna hop right back over here, and I'm gonna put it right underneath the other section. Notice that gives me a web preview link. Now when I do this, there's two choices. I can leave it this size, or I can right click it and view it small. Viewing it as small is going to allow me to easily add a bunch of these links onto this note without making the note 1,000 pages long. Let's do it for the next one. I'm gonna click on it. Then I'm going to grab the website right here and drag it right back in just like that. Right click it, view it as small. One more time. Let's click on the link. Let's grab the icon. Let's drag and drop it. Right click, view as small. Now by doing this, we've not only beautified this note, but we've given ourselves a little bit of additional information and a way to jump directly to the website easily, along with a preview of what that website's going to give us. We could really use a couple of maps on this itinerary to help us find our way around. Let's hop back over to Safari here, and I've done some searches for specific maps of Kyoto and Tokyo. Now all I have to do is right-click and copy this image and bring myself back over to my note here. And in this case, let's put them down at the bottom along with the guidebooks. There's the first one. Let's come back over to Safari. Let's grab the Tokyo one. This time I'm just gonna drag it right over, pop it right into the note here. And there we go. We've got our Kyoto map and our Tokyo map right in our itinerary, ready for us to utilize. but there's still a couple of things that we can do to kick this up just a notch. Right here, we can add an entire section for our flight info, the airline, the flight number, when we depart, when we arrive, the confirmation number, everything that you need to have access to make this trip an unmitigated success. And there's just a few more tips to make this itinerary perfect. And the first one is making sure that we share this itinerary with anyone we're traveling with. We can do that by clicking the share button in the upper right-hand corner here and making sure it's set to collaborate. This will mean that if our fellow traveler wants to add additional hotels or restaurants or other information into our itinerary, he can do that from his computer, his phone, his iPad, even from iCloud.com, making it super simple for him to participate on this amazing vacation we've got planned. Now, let's come in and share this note. I'm going to do it via messages. That's going to open up my messages app and ask me who I want to share it with. Let's just send him a little message letting him know that we're super excited to have him on this trip, and then let's click send. When he gets that and accepts it, he will have access to this note and all of the information that we've got on this note, making it a perfect vacation. Almost. In just a moment, I'm going to reveal my MacWhisperer power tip. And if you thought what we talked about today was cool, just sit tight, because this power tip is a complete game changer. But before I do, if you've already gotten great value out of this lesson, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. That makes it so much easier for other people to find it. And if you have suggestions or comments about better ways to create itineraries or things that are missing from this one, drop it down in the comments section. I love to hear from you guys. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I'm not gonna take you to Japan with me. So there. Or you can just subscribe and make it easy for everyone, and then we can go see Kyoto and Japan together. Just saying. That being said, it is now time for our MacWhisperer power tip. In the most recent version of Apple Notes, they added an amazing and powerful function called linking notes. This allows you to take one note and link other notes into it in a super simple way. And an itinerary is a perfect place to do that. Let's say that while planning this trip, we've created a couple of additional notes, like restaurants we want to go to, hotels we've heard about that we'd like to experience, and even some of the most important Japanese phrases that we need to know to make sure we don't sound like a foolish American on our vacation. It's great to have these separate notes, but by linking notes, we can take each of these separate notes and bring them directly into our travel itinerary. Let me show you how to do it. We're gonna go back to our itinerary here, and right up at the top, we're gonna just come in and we're going to give ourselves some new resources. From here, I can right click in order to add a link. When you go to add a link, you can start typing the name of any note in your entire notes app, and it will find them. No problem, but there's an even easier way to do that that I prefer, which is by using the greater than symbol. If you type the greater than symbol twice, just like that, it'll bring up your list and it will focus on the most recently created ones. Here's our Japanese phrases right there. Greater than, greater than. Here's the Japanese hotels. And here is our Japanese restaurants. It's such a helpful tool that you can tie other notes into this itinerary that it makes it even more valuable. And on top of just basic resources, there might be all sorts of other information. For example, down here, we know we're going to karaoke. Now, I don't know about you, but I love karaoke, and I've created a list of songs that I love to sing at karaoke. Would be really helpful when I get to this karaoke bar that I actually have that list of songs without hunting around for it. No problem, we'll just do our little greater than trick, and I'm gonna type right in karaoke. And there it is, my karaoke songs list right here. Now, when I open up this document on my phone, carrying it around with me easily through the entire Japanese trip, anytime I need information, I can simply click on one of these links and it will open up that specific note, allowing me to easily and simply know what to say in Japanese or which hotels we should check out, or anything else. It makes it so easy to tie these separate pieces together. And if you follow all of my suggestions, you'll end up with an itinerary that looks like this, with a gorgeous title and a beautiful picture, with all of your flight information at the top, all of the separate resources with links to other notes that you've created, your entire itinerary laid out with locations and links and addresses and everything that you need to make this trip an unbelievable and unforgettable success. So that's what I've got. All about how to use Apple Notes to create a beautiful travel itinerary that you can carry around with you for your entire vacation right from the palm of your hands. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer. It's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I'll see you next time.